Mind the gap. Mind the gap.
The London Underground has been appearing on film since 1928, and it's as intrinsic to life in the nation's capital as Buckingham Palace or Big Ben. It's inseparable from London's cinematic landscape, whether serving as an air raid shelter in World War II, providing an enclosed setting for a fist fight, a way to split into alternative timelines, or simply a means for one of our favourite superheroes to catch up with a supervillain just a few stops away.
How do I get to Greenwich?
Take this train, 3 stops.
From the iconic signage of tube station entrances to confusing escalators, a labyrinth of creepy underground tunnels, and the trains themselves, there are seemingly limitless cinematic possibilities. A single image instantly establishes a London film, whether it actually uses the underground or not. Celebrated director Anthony Asquith was the first to recognise its cinematic potential when he used Waterloo as the primary setting for his feature Underground, a love triangle between an electrician, a shop girl and a porter. Underground shows the busyness of the trains and platforms and the variety of people they serve as it connects the lives, loves and concerns of ordinary people in this now familiar cinematic environment. Never to be outdone, the following year, Britain's most famous director, Alfred Hitchcock, also took to the underground for a cameo in his first sound film. By the time England reached the Second World War, underground stations had taken on an additional role, that of an air raid shelter to protect Londoners against the bombings of the Blitz. And this was never seen more poignantly than in the 1941 documentary, Christmas Under Fire. Atonement also shows the underground as a place for shelter, though this time with real-life tragic consequences when a ruptured waterline floods Balham Station, killing more than 60 people. The underground is a place for everyone, so it's to here Winston Churchill travels in the completely fictional scene in Darkest Hour where he discusses his leadership choices with ordinary people. This is a place we can all be equal, even with a wartime prime minister.
If the worst came to pass, and the enemy were to appear on those streets above, what would you do?
Fight.
Fight the fascists.
Fight them with anything we can lay our hands on.
Broom handles if we must.
Street by street.
They'll never take Piccadilly.
This wartime notion of the underground as a place for refuge and safety recurs in British science fiction films of the 60s. In Dalek's Invasion Earth, 2150 AD, the Doctor and his fellow travellers are transported to a London of the future, and the landscape immediately recalls London during the Blitz.
Daleks!
Although the story doesn't involve Nazis, the Daleks' drive for domination and enslavement creates a familiar plotline, and the location of the human safety and resistance seems completely logical. Wartime memories are also evoked in Quatermass and the Pit, when a mysterious capsule is discovered underground in the fictional station of Hobbs End. Thought to be an unexploded German bomb, the vessel is in fact a 50 million years old spaceship containing aliens who can control human minds. God. Written by Nigel Neal and produced by horror specialists Hammer, the film was possibly the first to make use of the subterranean creepiness of the underground, and a number of frightening scenes usher in one of the most effective uses of this location in films. A place for horror. 1972's Deathline begins when two students travelling home late at night discover an unconscious man on the platform at Russell Square. The dimly lit circular corridors and steep platform steps are emphasised in the cinematography, as is the slow creep of the late night trains. The turning point of the film is a stunning 7-minute tracking shot that travels through a disused tunnel from the home of the last survivor of an accident many years earlier. A reminder that Mind the Gap was formerly Mind the Doors.
Mind the Doors!
serves the plot as the only words the unfortunate survivor can speak.
Thank you, Lord.
This visual study of the tube's inherent spookiness was interestingly made by an American director, and it was another American who again chose the underground for a major set piece in his 1981 film, An American Werewolf in London. When two American students visiting England lose their way, and one of them is bitten by a werewolf, chaos ensues, and in spite of a spectacular finale in Leicester Square, the best remembered scene in the film is undoubtedly this increasingly claustrophobic chase through the brightly lit tunnel-like corridors of Tottenham Court Road, the feeling of entrapment and fear emphasized by the keen use of smooth tracking shots and wide-angle lenses. These two visual approaches to underground horror are combined in 2014's Creep, which after an unlikely setup progresses through all the visual tropes of underground horror we would wish to see. 28 Days Later briefly uses an underground sweet shop at Canary Wharf as a place for respite, but its sequel, 28 Weeks Later, contains a full-blown chase sequence where our protagonists literally drive into a derelict station while under pursuit before a horrific encounter on the platform below. The tunnels, escalators, and maze-like geography of the underground are perfect for chase scenes. The filmmakers have taken advantage since 1935, when in Bulldog Jack there is both a fight in the tunnel and a chase on a train. Not so dissimilar to Fast and Furious 6 and Skyfall, almost 80 years later. The underground is so woven into the fabric of our everyday lives, it seems that almost any film set in London must include a scene here. It's a place for chases, fights, romance, decision-making, horror, and the most extraordinary adventures. In life, it lives with us, grows with us, and ages with us. And like us, it weathers good times and bad. A witness to our lives, it's more than just a way to travel from one place to another. It's a living, breathing part of London, and the pulse to many of our most ordinary adventures.
Mind the gap. Mind.